Hi everyone, today I'm going to be discussing my review of the M1 Mac Mini. This is the 16GB model, but besides that, everything else is base config. I've had this again for over a month now, and as a video producer and content creator, I'm going to give you some insights on how it worked for me. So just as a point of view, I was coming from this. This is a 2018 MacBook Pro, 6 cores, 32GB. It was the top spec machine at the time in late 2018. It costed a fortune. And then this, of course, is just the base level Mac Mini with the 16GB of RAM upgrade. And because we've all been quarantined, I actually saw this as a trial run to see if maybe I could use a desktop machine instead of a portable going forward, because we know Apple's going to come out with some new iMacs. And I've always wanted to use an iMac, but I wasn't sure maybe if I'm an iMac person or do I really just at the end of the day need a portable computer. Well, 1 month later of using the Mac Mini and not really using my MacBook Pro, I actually got really used to it. I have to say, I was really uncomfortable at the start because again, you're so used to having portability. If I'm doing everything at my desk, a desktop machine is perfect for me. I mean, it's so much faster than, you know, a laptop traditionally is. But the Mac Mini really opened my eyes up to having a desktop computer, and I'm really, really enjoying it. Now, you folks already know this from watching other videos, but yes, the Mac Mini is super fast. Everything turns on as fast as you think it would. I went back to my old MacBook to get some files off of it, and I was just so shocked by how slow it took to open up like a web browser. Now, speaking of web browsers, we all know that Google Chrome is a bit of a memory hog. With this, I am using Safari, and I am resisting to use Google Chrome. I've been at it for a month. I have not needed to use Google Chrome, and I'm trying to stay away from it. I'm really enjoying the new Safari. I haven't really used iPhone or iPad apps on the M1 Mac Mini yet. I haven't found a reason to do so. Again, I'm in a very specific line of work with the video editing and the video production. I am so happy to tell you that video editing is amazing on the Mac Mini M1. I'm a Final Cut Pro user, and if you are going to be a Final Cut Pro user, it is as fast as everybody says it is. I had no trouble making 4K videos at around 24 or 25 frames or 1080p 60. So what really impressed me was how great the HEVC or the H.265 codec is. When you're doing your exporting your deliverable master in that type of format, the exports are so fast with the M1 chip, it was really impressive. In terms of 4K, I was getting about a 2:1 speed. So if you had a 10 minute video, 4K would export in about 5 minutes. I actually do have a bit of news for you though. 1080p at 60 frames is a bit slower than that. Now I have it written down here because I was doing my research and I was taking notes. But I actually found with a 1:45 video that took 1 hour and 2 minutes when I was exporting at 1080p 60. Now, of course, the edits were very different. This 4K video had a lot more effects, but I mean, the 1080p video also had a few effects on them, but that's just a really interesting takeaway that I found about exporting with the H.265 codec, is that 4K at a lower frame rate seems to be more optimized for the transcoder than a lower resolution with a higher frame rate. Of course, what everybody talks about is about the new M1 Max is that they're very quiet, they're not too hot to touch, and yes, it does hold up. So when I've been doing intense editing on this, and again, in Final Cut Pro, I had to use After Effects a few times that hasn't been updated for M1, but I did notice that, you know, during the intense editing and all the exporting, this Mac Mini never got hot. You never heard a fan run and it never got hot. It gets a tiny bit warm, but just to give you a comparison, I'd actually say that my SSD, my SanDisk Extreme, when that's being used, that would be actually a tad bit warmer than the Mac Mini itself. So if you're a user who uses external SSDs like the SanDisk Extreme, your Mac Mini would actually be a bit cooler than that. My experience with hardware has been mixed. I found when I was using the Logitech unifying receiver for my keyboard and mouse, that worked perfectly. I plug it into my Mac Mini, no trouble. I love the unifying receiver. The battery life on my keyboard and mouse actually lasts much longer than Bluetooth. But I also have this very professional color calibrator. Again, I do a lot of video work, and sometimes I do have to do color work. If it's really high budget, I outsource that, but I have to do it in-house. I do it myself, so I have to color calibrate my monitor, excuse me. And this one here I have is the X-Rite I1 Display Plus. This is one of the industry leading ones that we all use. It's very high end. This does not work with the M1 Mac Mini just yet. When you plug it in, it just can't do it. It doesn't recognize what's going on. I spoke to X-Rite. They are coming out with new software for the M1 Mac Mini. They said by the end of Q1, although we're coming into March. So what I actually had to do was calibrate the monitor connected to my MacBook Pro. and then I had to copy over that color profile from the MacBook Pro to the Mac Mini. So there is a way to do it if you have an older Intel Mac. And if you work in another industry like audio, check your audio peripherals. If you work with embedded systems or, you know, IoTs, just be really careful and double check that they do work with the M1 Mac Mini. Because on a related note, on a more home consumer level note, I can also report that my printer does not work with the M1 Mac Mini. I have a printer out there. It's a very old printer, to be honest with you, but it doesn't work with the M1 Mac Mini. So what we actually did was I have the home iMac computer in the office, and that's just turned on 24/7, and I turned on printer sharing. So when I print from this, it's using the iMac printer sharing feature, and that's how I can print to the printer, which you might be able to do if you have several computers. Go for it. But I will just say that it's a brother printer, and they did not release a driver for the M1 Mac Mini. And I feel like talking about compatibility is a great way to kind of go into the cons of the Mac Mini, because I was very positive there in the beginning. There's nothing really too important when it comes to cons. The main ones, again, is ports. Can you believe it? Even though there's USB-A and USB-C, I'm actually in a scenario where I transitioned most of my devices to USB-C. I bought new wires, I upgraded my hardware. And again, that's why I have the Logitech unifying receiver just stuck into the USB-A port, because I have no other use for it. And then maybe I use the second one for like a USB thumb drive, but that's really about it. But as you can see here, all my USB-C ports are full. My first one has a SanDisk Extreme SSD, which is always plugged in for editing. And then my USB-C hub, I need that for an SD card reader, because this doesn't have an SD card reader. So I could have really done with like a third or a fourth USB-C port. And that's really interesting, because the MacBook Pro only has four USB-C ports. And of course, if you have it plugged in to charge, you're down to three. I think having even just one extra USB-C port would have made a whole huge difference for me. Because if there's a second hard drive, for example, that I need to work off of, I don't like to work those off of hubs, because I do worry about data integrity and hubs aren't that reliable. So if there was actually a third USB-C port I could plug a drive straight into, that would be so much better. So what's going to be different with this video review is that I'm basically going to help you answer any questions you may have about it by dropping a comment down below. Again, I've been using this for a month and I've been very happy with it, but I'm not really sure what to talk about unless you guys have anything really specific. Again, I'm really enjoying using this computer. And to sum it up, as I suppose as a conclusion, I've never been excited about Macs for a very long time. This has made me really excited about the Mac platform. I think we come from a really low point with the MacBook Pro era. I really didn't like my MacBook Pro, and that was the most amount of money I ever spent on a Mac computer. Usually the MacBook Pros in Ireland would cost around, you know, somewhere in the 2000s. I spent much more on that MacBook Pro, and that was the most unsatisfied I ever was. And this is probably the cheapest Mac I ever owned. It was like under 1,000, it was 9 something. And it's been just so fantastic. I've been extremely excited about what the future of the Mac is. Again, this won't be permanent when Apple comes out with a new MacBook or a new iMac. I will upgrade this as temporary, but I was just so happy to get away from the MacBook Pro. And I am so much happier with the Mac Mini. But if you have any specific questions about the Mac Mini, do drop a comment down below and let me know. And I'll try to help you again with general Mac Mini questions. Or if you work in video or video production, I might be able to help you out here. Hopefully the insights I gave you earlier would be helpful to you. I don't see many people talking about hardware, so I just really wanted to make it really clear that wouldn't work with the color calibrator. And you do have to be very careful with your peripherals. If you liked the video, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to stay tuned for future uploads. But other than that, I hope you guys are keeping safe and well, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye everybody.